Hello everyone, welcome on my channel. Today I'm going to show you how to crochet this beautiful doily. This is the quite small project because I am using this doily for Easter basket. So basically my doily is measured about 10.5 inches in diameter, and for this project I am using crochet hook size 1.25 millimeters and the thread in size 10. So for this project you will need less than 50 gram ball, but if you would like to make this project bigger, you can use crochet hook size up to 1.75 millimeters for the same size of the thread. So if you are new on my channel, don't forget to subscribe, and now let's get started. Our project, we have to start by making slip knot. Then chain of 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and 6. Slip stitch into the first chain to make a ring. And we are going to start first strand, chain 1, then into our ring we have to work 12 single crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 and 12. Slip stitch in first single crochet. So our first round we've got done. Our second round, we are going to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet. Then into the same stitch we have to make one more double crochet. So we've got 2 double crochets in one stitch. Now in each single crochet we have to make 2 double crochets. So we are going to have 24 double crochets in total. 1 and 2. Then 1 and 2. One and two. And the same pattern all the way around, 2 double crochets in each single crochet. Round number 3, after slip stitch into the top of chain 3 in our previous round, we have to start by making chain of 3 as a first double crochet again. So at the end we need to work slip stitch into the first chain as well. And now into the same stitch we need to make 1 double crochet again. Into the second we have to make 1 double crochet. Then 2 double crochets into the next one. 1 and 2. 1 double crochet in next stitch. Then 2 double crochets in next one. 1 and 2. 1 double crochet in next stitch. Then 2 double crochets in next one. 1 double crochet in next stitch, then 2 double crochets in next one. 1 and 2. So the same pattern we are going to continue all the way around. At the end we should have 36 double crochets. So as you can see, we've got 2, 1, 2, 1, 2 and now 1. Round 4, we are going to start in exactly the same way. So chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then double crochet in the same stitch. So again we've got 2 double crochets in one stitch, 1 double crochet in next stitch. 2 double crochets in first stitch, 1 and 2, then 1 double crochet in next. 2 double crochets in next stitch, 1 and 2, then 1 double crochet in next, 2 double crochets in next one, 1 and 2, and double crochet in next. So now we have to continue the same pattern all the way around. So the same as in our previous one. 2, 1, 2, 1, 2 and 1. And at the end we should have 54 double crochets. Now we are going to start round number 5 and we need to start by making chain 1, then one single crochet in our first stitch. So in the same stitch as we've done slip stitch. Single crochet in next stitch and basically in each stitch all the way around we have to make one single crochet. So we are going to have another 54 single crochets, the same as we've done double crochets in our previous round. So just continue and I will back to you on the beginning of round number 5. Round number 6 we are going to start by making chain 1, then into the same single crochet as we finished previous round we have to work single crochet again. Chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now skip next 2 stitches, one single crochet in third. Chain of 5. Skip next 2 stitches, single crochet in third. Chain of 5 and 5. Skip next 3 stitches, single crochet in fourth. So 2, 2, now 3 and again. Chain of 5. Skip 2 stitches, 1, 2, single crochet in third. Chain of 5. Skip next 2 stitches, single crochet in third. Chain of 5. Skip next 3 stitches, single crochet in fourth. Chain of 5. Skip next 2 stitches, single crochet in third. Chain 5. Skip next 2 stitches, single crochet in third. Chain of 5. Skip next 3 stitches, single crochet in fourth. Chain of 5 and again 2 times we have to skip chain 2 stitches and single crochet in third. 4, 5. The next one we have to skip 3. 1, 2, 3. So basically all the way around we should have 16 chain 5 spaces. So now again we have to skip first 2 in third single crochet. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Next 2 single crochet in third. And at the end, so we should have now 14. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13 and 14. At the end we have to skip 2 times 3 stitches. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Skip 1, 2, 3 in fourth single crochet. 3, 4, 5. Skip next 3. 1, 2, 3 and fourth. So in our first single crochet we have to make slip stitch. Round 7 we are going to start after slip stitch in our first single crochet by making slip stitch into the first chain stitch. Now chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then into the same chain space we have to make 2 double crochets, 1 and 2, then chain of 15, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. Then into the same chain space we have to make another 3 double crochets. 1 two and three. Single crochet in next chain space, then into the third, again three double crochets, one, two, and three. Chain of 15, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, then 3 double crochets in the same chain space, 1, two and three. Single crochet in next chain space, and now again in next one three double crochets, chain 15, then another three double crochets, then in next single crochet. So the same pattern now we have to repeat all the way around. In last one we need to work single crochet and slip stitch into the top of chain 3, so in our first double crochet. And the same repeat we should have 8. So 8 chain 15 spaces and exactly the same 8 single crochets. At the end of our round, after the first after the last single crochet, we have to work slip stitch into the top of chain 3, so into the first double crochet. Then we are going to start round number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, round number 8. We need to drop our loop, insert crochet hook into the single crochet, then grab the yarn, and we need to start working from this single crochet. So chain 1, then single crochet in our single crochet, so this can be a little difficult, and wasn't that bad. And now after single crochet in our single crochet from previous round, we are going directly to the chain 15 space and we have to make 13 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. Then chain of 3 and 3, and into the same chain space another 13 double crochets, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 8, 9, sorry, 9, 10, 11, 12, and 13. So after second group of 13 double crochets, we have to work single crochet into the single crochet from our previous round. Now we can move our double crochets to form, so to make better look. And then we are going again to the next chain 15 space. And we have to work exactly the same. So we need to start by making 13 double crochets, then chain of 3, and another 13 double crochets. So after the second group of 13 double crochets, we have to work single crochet in next single crochet, and then again. So we should have 8 the same groups, so 13 double crochets, chain 3 and 13 double crochets, then single crochet. Round 9, after slip stitch in our first single crochet, now we have to make slip stitch in each double crochet until the last 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. So we have to work slip stitch in each double crochet. And we've got 1, 2, 3 into the fourth as well, and now chain one, then single crochet into the same stitch. So we are going to start from fourth double crochet before our chain three space. Now chain of 5, single crochet in chain three space, chain of 7, single crochet in the same chain three space, chain of 5, then single crochet in fourth double crochet after chain 3 space. So now we've got before and then after. Chain of 11, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. Then we have to go to the next group and we need to work single crochet again into the fourth double crochet before chain 3. Chain of 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, single crochet in chain 3 space, chain of 7, 1, 2, 3, 3, four, 5, 6 and 7, single crochet in the same chain space, chain of 5, 2, 3, 4, 5 and then single crochet in fourth double crochet. One more time, chain of 11, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. Then we have to go to the next, the fourth double crochet before the next chain 3 space and we have to make single crochet. Then chain of 5, single crochet in chain 3 space, chain 7 and again chain of 5. So the whole pattern have to be looks exactly the same all the way around. Chain 5, chain 7, chain 5, chain 11, chain 5, chain 7, chain 5 and chain 11. Now we are going to start round number 10 and after slip stitch into the single crochet we have to work slip stitch into the next 3 chain stitches of our first chain 5 space. Chain 1, then into the same chain space 1 single crochet. Now we are going directly to the chain 7 space and we have to make 11 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11, then single crochet in next chain 5 space. And now we've got chain 11 space and we have to work 13 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 and 13. Then single crochet in next chain 5 space and in chain 7 again 11 double crochets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10 and 11. Single crochet in chain 5 space and in next chain 11 space 13 double crochets. So exactly the same as we've done at the beginning. So here we need to work 13, then single crochet in chain 5 space, 11 in chain 7 space, single crochet in next chain 5 space and 13 double crochets again. So the same pattern we have to continue all the way around. Now we've got round 11. At the end of our previous round we have to work slip stitch in our first single crochet. Now we need to make slip stitch into the first double crochet, then chain 3 as a double crochet, chain 1 as a chain 1 space, then double crochet in next double crochet, chain 1, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 1, double crochet in next double crochet, chain 1, then double crochet in next double crochet, chain 1. So now in each double crochet, so we've got group of 11 double crochets, we have to work 1 double crochet and between chain 1 space. So we are going to have again 11 double crochets and 10 chain 1 spaces. So this is the last one, 11th double crochet, and now we have to skip single crochet and the next 3 double crochets. 1 single crochet into the 4th double crochet and then in next 6 double crochets. So we've got in total 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 and 7. 7 in total. The last 3 double crochets and chain space we have to skip as well, and double crochet in first double crochet. So again, we've got group of 11 double crochets. Double crochet, chain 1, then double crochet in next stitch, chain 1, double crochet in next stitch, chain 1, then into the next one, chain 1, into the next, chain 1, then into the next, and exactly in the same way as we've done at the beginning. So after our 11th double crochet, we have to basically skip 4 stitches. Single crochet, then next 3 double crochets, 7 double crochets, and again skip last 3 double crochets, single crochet, and go directly to the group of 11 double crochets. Now we've got round 12. So after slip stitch in our first double crochet, now we need to make chain of 3 as a first double crochet, and in our chain 1 space we are going to make 2 double crochets. 1 and 2. Double crochet in next double crochet, then 2 double crochets in next chain 1 space. 1 and 2. Double crochet next double crochet, then 2 double crochets in chain 1 space. 1 and 2. Double crochet in next double crochet, then 2 double crochets in chain 1 space. So now we are going to repeat the same pattern to the end of this part. So in our part we've got 11 double crochets and 10 chain 2 spaces. In each chain and 10 chain 1 spaces. In each chain 1 space we need to make 2 double crochets, so this is a 20 double crochets plus 11 from each double crochet. So in total, in our part, we should have 31 double crochets. So this is looks like a big one so far. And I've got only a few more stitches to do. Double crochet into the double crochet, 2 double crochets in chain 1 space, double crochet next double crochet, two double crochets in chain one space, double crochet, next double crochet, so this is actually the last one. And now after the last one, 31st double crochet, we have to skip first three single crochets, then we need to make one single crochet into the fourth, and now again skip next three single crochets and make one double crochet into the next double crochet. So this is the next group, and basically we have to start repeat what we've done from the beginning. So double crochet in each double crochet and two double crochets in each chain one space. So the pattern is staying exactly the same. After last double crochet, we have to skip next three stitches, next three single crochets and one single crochet into the fourth. So just continue and I will go back at the beginning of the next round. Round 13, we are going to start after slip stitch into the top of chain 3 by making chain 1, then single crochet in double crochet. And now we have to make one single crochet in each double crochet all the way around. So not in each stitch, because each single crochet between motifs we have to skip. We need to finish single crochet in last double crochet and then go directly to the first in next group. So single crochet we have to skip all the time. So this is very easy round to do. Just continue with single crochets in each double crochet, and I will go back to you at the beginning of round number 14. Round number 14, we need to start after slip stitch into the first single crochet by making slip stitch in next three stitches, 1, 2, and 3. We have to skip first three single crochets and we need to start from the fourth one by making chain of 3 as a double crochet, then chain 2 as a chain 2 space. Then we have to skip first single crochet, one double crochet into the second, chain 2, skip next stitch, double crochet into the second, 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 chain 2 space, skip next stitch, double crochet into the second. So now the same pattern, we have to continue until we will have the last 3 single crochets. So each time after double crochet we have to make chain 2 space and then we need to skip first stitch and make double crochet into the second single crochet from our previous round. So I've got only few left, I think 2, chain of 2, skip first one double crochet into the next one, and as you can see we've got last three single crochets on our first part, then we need to skip next three single crochets on the second part, and into the fourth we have to work double crochet. So in exactly the same way as we just started our round. So on both sides we have to skip three single crochets at the beginning and at the end. So here we've got 6 single crochets and now we need to repeat. So chain of 2, skip first one, double crochet into the second, then again chain 2, skip first one, double crochet into the second, chain of 2, skip first one, double crochet into the second, chain 2, skip first one, double crochet into the second, and the same pattern we have to continue all the way around. So between two groups we are not working any chain stitches. We have to work double crochet in last fourth single crochet, and then directly we are going to the fourth single crochet in next group. Chain two spaces, we are working only between double crochets, just on our parts, not between. Now we are going to start the last one around, round 15, and after slip stitch into the top of chain 3, now again chain of 3 as a first double crochet, then 2 double crochets in chain 2 space, 1 and 2, double crochet into the double crochet, and now chain of 4, 3 and 4, then slip stitch into the last double crochet. So now we've got picot on the top of our double crochet. Two double crochets in chain two space, 1 and 2, then double crochet into the double crochet, and again chain of 4, slip stitch in our last double crochet. So we've got picot on the top of the double crochet, and again two double crochets in chain two space, then double crochet into the double crochet, chain of 4, slip stitch into the last double crochet, and again two double crochets in chain two space, then double crochet into the double crochet, and again we have to work picot by making chain of 4 and slip stitch in our last double crochet. Now we have to continue the same pattern to the last double crochet, and then I will show you what we have to do next. Now I've done my last two double crochets in last chain two space, and I've got my last double crochet in first motif. So now into the last double crochet we have to work only the first part of the double crochet, then into the space between two motifs we have to make first part of the double crochet as well, and then first part of the double crochet in next double crochet. So this is the first double crochet of the next motif. So we are working three double crochets together, and now we need to work through all four loops. At the top of our three double crochets together we have to work picot again. So chain of 4, then we need to insert crochet hook into the all three double crochets. So we need to grab all four loops, then work slip stitch, and we've got picot on the top of our three double crochets together. From now we have to repeat the same pattern as we've done before. Two double crochets in chain two space, then double crochet into the double crochet, chain of 4, slip stitch into the double crochet, and again two double crochets in next chain two space, 1 and 2, then double crochet in next double crochet, chain of 4, and slip stitch on the top of the double crochet. So now the same pattern we have to continue all the way around. So each time at the end we have to work first part of the double crochet, into the space between motifs another one, and into the first double crochet as well. So basically now when we go back to the beginning and we start our work with chain 3 as a double crochet, here into the last one we have to make only the first part of the double crochet, into the space another one, then slip stitch into the top of chain 3 and picot on the top of our last three double crochets together. Then we can fasten off and cut the yarn. So that's it for today. Thank you for staying with me to the end of this tutorial. If you like this project, just put your thumbs up, and see you in the next tutorial. Have a nice day.